Thank you for watching True Vine Victory Hour, located here in New Britain, Connecticut, 477 Ellis Street, where Jesus is Lord and everybody is somebody. Reverend Walter Simmons, pastor, co-pastor Evangelist Priscilla Simmons, our order of service, Sunday school, Sunday morning, 9:30 a.m., morning worship service, 10:30 a.m., Wednesdays, 6 p.m., prayer and Bible class combined. Program airing time is 6 o'clock p.m. every Sunday, Channel 5, Nutmeg TV. We are God creation. We are all created with a deep thirst for God in our heart, an empty longing that only God can satisfy. We try to quench that thirst with so many things: significant success, comfort, peace, wisdom. But all these things, however is good, cannot meet our deepest need. At the root of it, we thirst for our closeness to our Creator, God Almighty. Our goal is to continue to reach the lost at any cost. Feed the hungry, clothe the naked, and visit the sick and shut in. Help our youth or tomorrow find the peace which passes all.
Visitor here for a couple weeks, pretty much a week. So, but it's been a good visit. My youngest, from California, so she's a busy young lady. We both have our different opinions. We can both be alike, but we can both be totally different also. But that's who we are. But she is mine.
Amen.
As we say, she belongs to me.
Amen. Us too.
But our lesson is entitled Rebellion of the People. And we've been kind of continuing this lesson on a regular basis over the last few weeks. Mm-hmm. And one thing about the Israelites, you know what? They are just like us. If you put up a mirror and you look inside of it, some of the things that they did is what we do. You know, last week we talked about the spies. You know, God doesn't need spies to go someplace else, but God does these things to give us a sense of belief. Mm-hmm. So we know that, you know, help us out with some of our decisions. You know, we all do that in life. You know, when we look for a new house, guess what? We go to venture and see what the neighborhood looks like. That's like the spies going around and see what things are like. We start a new job, we may go in there a little bit to see what it looks like. Is what the Israelites did. You know, God knows what's there for us, but sometimes, you know what, we have to do certain things to make us supposedly feel a little better. Now, this is after the spies had already went in there, and we know that Moses had sent 12 to go throughout the country so that people had an idea of what it was like, make them feel a little better. They came from Egypt, and all this traveling, and now, you know, it was about that time. And they went through a lot of things. You know, the Israelites, you saw say they were on board and then they got off. They were on board and then they got off. And they kept doing it on a regular basis. And think about that same thing with ourselves also. As we mature through life, believe it or not, we're on board and we get off. And we're off board and we get on. And we get to a point of life, believe it or not, we stay on board. Somewhere along the line, we learn how to mature. And the Israelites, they were learning how to mature as they were going through life. Now we're at a point right now that all the information is coming back. And as we know, two of us were going to the new land, and everybody else says, you know what, we can't go there because it's fearful. And it's like, I use the example of us men, we go out fishing, and you know, we say, well, I got a big one. I got a big fish. But you may not have seen that big fish, but we say, I got a big fish. The fish may not have been like that, but we got a big fish. Huge fish. And everybody around us, they all say, we caught a big fish. But it may be only a few that actually knew what the fish actually looked like. So, once again, as these spies are there and they're going out throughout the country, and what they do is they come back and they bring the report. And the report was, were afraid of these people, for most of them. A couple of them said, you know what, we can take over this land. And you know, sometimes we're fearful for God that's taking us to where we're at right now. And we have a tendency to bring up almost every excuse that we can not to go forward. You know, think of us like right now where we're at right now. We've come to many points that have said, you know what, I don't want to go there because of X, Y, Z. I'm afraid of going there because of X, Y, Z. I don't want to go to that neighborhood because of whatever. But we have to understand that, you know, when we get certain things, if God is with us, He's going to be with us.
Amen.
He doesn't bring us from all the way back there to here just to say, let you go. He doesn't do that. If you look at our history has been that way also. Think about where you've come from in your past. Mm-hmm. And think about where you're at right now. Mm-hmm. And think about how many times you might have said, you know what? I don't like it. I want to change. Mm-hmm. And I remember when I first moved into this state, and as the kids were coming up, one of the biggest gripes about the state was that there was no music. They didn't like the radio stations. The radio stations, they couldn't get anything. You go back West Coast, you got all the music. What we have here, and nothing wrong. Mm. But now, you know, the music has changed, and some of them, they kind of accept that a little bit. You know, and the young folks, they're trying to change a little bit as they go forward. But if you look back where they're at, they don't like that at all. Mm-hmm. Look at where they're at right now. You know, I call her my little one. And she was always the vocal one. She still is always the vocal one. She's very opinionated. But there's nothing wrong with that. But sometimes you have to express your faith in a proper fashion. She doesn't do it in a disobedient way, but she does it in a proper fashion because that's who she is. Part of me, believe it or not, is still that one. That's right back there. Part of a mother, a lot of a mother isn't that one back there also. So all that. But that's who we are. We don't come from some place that's to be dropped off. We learn things as we go through our life. And this is one of the things that the people, the Israelites, they kind of forgotten. And I'm going to start reading the lesson. This is coming from Numbers, the 14th chapter, the 1st and the 12th verse. It's regular English. And of course, when the report came back, the spies were giving their report. And 14 starts off like this. That night, all the people of the community raised their voices and wept aloud because they were so afraid. All the Israelites grumbled against Moses and Aaron, and the whole assembly said to them, if only we had died in Egypt or in this desert. Why is the Lord bringing us to this land only to let us fall by the sword? You know, even about all, everything that they've come through and all that they saw, all that God did, there's something there. And once I said before, you think about ourselves also. Look at all that God has done for us from all of our years. And most of us grew up in a few years there. So we've really seen everything that God has done for us in all those years. We saw the good, we saw the bad, and we saw the fruit that's truly there. And we said, you know, wow, God has really brought me through a mighty long ways. And it looks like He's going to take me a little bit further. But we have to understand that He's always with us. No matter what goes on. Sometimes we have to learn things throughout the way. And sometimes He just has to show us how to get there. And the Israelites, they had a good life, believe it or not. You know, but when they wanted meat, they got quail. When they wanted bread, there was manna. Out in the desert, they had water. They had all the things that they asked for, and it was given to them. Like ourselves, so many things that are given to us, and guess what? We still grumble. You look inside the refrigerator, there's no meat inside the refrigerator. I want some meat. You know. But when we were coming up, the rice and beans was more than enough. But right now, we'll say, I got to have some chicken. Why am I having chicken every day? I want beef. I want pork. I want a mission.
Yeah.
This is what we say.
Yeah.
But you know what? We've been given so much. Just like the Israelites. Same way, they were grumbling. And guess what? We still grumble too. But we've been given so much. You know, we talk about our jobs, but I wish I had a great job. And now that we've gotten a good job, great job, we still grumble, you know, because as we say, I'm not getting paid enough. Well, you know what? Think about where we were. God has truly blessed us. And this is those folks that, you know, they couldn't see that. And it's just like work, and just like Israelites there. You can talk to the masses at work, and they'll tell you, why do you want to work for this place? Why do you want to do this, and why do you want to do that? And there's a few that said, you know what? Life is good. And just like with the Israelites, there was a couple that said, life is good. We can take this land. But everybody else says, they're too big. We can't do it. We brought all this way just to fail. And when God makes a promise, he makes a promise. He doesn't go back on that promise. That promise is etched in stone. And they went on to say this. Our wives and children will be taken as plunder. Wouldn't it be better for us to go back to Egypt? And they said to each other, we should choose a leader and go back to Egypt. Now, why would you want to go back to someone who won once you hit the plate? You know, when you get back, it's going to be a lot harder. And what you had, guess what? What you have right now, you don't have. And why would you want to go back to someone who's totally angry at you? Disrespect you. And go back there. And they said, let's choose a leader so we can go back. And one of the promises God made was that you will not see those people again once you leave this country. That promise was still there. And the fifth says this, then Moses and Aaron fell face down in front of the whole Israelite assembly gathered. There Joshua, son of Nun, and Caleb, son of Jehephunneh, who were among those who had explored the land, tore their clothes and said to the entire assembly, the land we passed through and explored is exceedingly good. Now they were given a good report. The food is good. It's a good land. And one thing that God did for the Israelites as they were coming across, you know, there were a lot that were deceased, but he grew them in numbers also. Because they were in great numbers as they were coming to this new land. You know, so if you look at all these folks, you look at a big army.
Listen, get to my point here. If the Lord is pleased with us, he will lead us into the land, a land flowing with milk and honey, and he will give it to us. Only do not rebel against the Lord, and do not be afraid of the people of the land, because we will swallow them up. You know, there were so many people, they were ready to take it over. The two, that's what they said. If God is on my side, I have nothing to fear. As we go through each and every day, one of the few things you're going to see also, when God is on my side, I have nothing to fear. I can conquer all. One thing about Liv, she knows I have my little fears. And she's a young lady, she's on her own. And I fear this every day. And she knows that. You're on your own, and you got through the whole 9 yards. Being a father, I still want a baby. But being a daughter, she tells me, I'm grown. It's time for me to grow. There's a lot that I've learned. Thank you for the foundation. But there's a lot for me to learn. And you know what? I'm a grown up now. And that's what she kind of says. Mm-hmm. But the dad in me says, you know what? I'm afraid. You know what? I really don't want you to grow. But she's grown. Nothing I can do about that. She's grown right now. The only thing that I can do is appreciate the foundation that she has in me. She carries part of it as she goes forward. And that I can look back and I can say, you know what? I'm proud of that. You know, what she may do or what she may say, I'm proud of the person that she is. Because part of that foundation is still there. And believe it or not, but I know that God is good. That I do know. I can say that. I can say he's with all my kids. Whether they believe that or not, I know that God is with them. So that's one thing we have to understand that God. We have to take away those fears. Understand that God is with you, no matter what we do. And we have to hold true to that. Sometimes we forget about that. that God, we think that God is not with us. We look at our lives and think that's so terrifying that so many things have gone wrong, that God is not with us. But you know what? God is with each and every one of us.
Amen. Amen.
Look at us. You know, I think about, when I was reading the lesson, I was thinking about this child. You know, and she was coming up, as we saw her, she was coming up, you know, and you know, you say, well, what's going to happen to her when she comes up? But if you look at her now, she's a young woman with that little one that's right next to her that she's teaching.
Yeah.
And that's a wonderful thing.
Amen.
That's truly a blessing. You know, because, you know, we know about the height issues, but that one right there, that's a blessing right there.
Amen.
And that's something that we cannot take away.
Mm-hmm.
Because we understand that God blesses us in His own way.
Amen.
And that's truly a blessing. I look back there each every day. That's truly a blessing. You just start to sing a song, and you got someone who's going to get up here faster than what you can do there. Tambourine in hand. Here it is. I got my song. I'm ready to go. So I was, I forget the name of that song. But that's what they used to, there's a song they used to all sing when they came up here. There's a little one there. She has her own special song.
Mm-hmm.
And all you got to do is just think about it. Say one tune, and she's running up. She really is. Once again, that's a blessing. It truly is. So, we're going further here. I'm going to lose my place every now and then. But the whole, whole assembly talked about stoning them, because, you know, they were saying the wrong thing. You know, Jacob and Caleb were saying, you know what, we can take this place. And the assembly says, you know what, I don't want that.
Mm.
You know, we need to go back. We got the wrong leaders.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
But they're saying that God is with me and we need to go forward. So they were ready to stone him. Then the glory of the Lord appeared at the tent of meeting to all the Israelites. The Lord said to Moses, imagine what the Lord said, how long will these people treat me with contempt? That's what he said. You know, this is what I'm doing, but how long will these people treat me with contempt? How long will they refuse to believe in me in spite of all the miraculous signs I have performed among them? And think about ourselves also, because sometimes we say that. There's folks that we know that constantly doubt God. And think of everything that He's done. This world is still going 24 hours.
Amen.
It goes around.
Mm-hmm.
It goes around the sun in 365 days, sometimes 366 days. Still does that. Hasn't changed.
Mm-hmm.
That's something miraculous by itself. Mm-hmm. Those other planets, they're still out there. And guess what? For as old as the earth is, we still have oxygen in this world. We can still get up in the morning and breathe. We can still get up in the morning and look at one another and touch one another. You know what? And say thank you for all the things that God has done.
Mm-hmm.
We passed us 94 years. Some of it will be a tough 94 years, but He's still 94 years.
Mm-hmm.
And He's seen a lot. And think about everything that you've seen over all the time that we've been around.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're hearing about this one thing that we would never see, thought about in our lifetime, a pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
Who would have even thought about that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I actually thought that our life that we lived, it was going so fast that, you know what, God found a way just to slow us down just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Because we had to slow a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Teach a little bit about our relationships. This has been a pandemic that has taught us a lot about our relationships. You know, believe it or not. Because when you're in-house, the one another changes things. Totally different. You go so fast in the basketball practice, I got the ball game, I got this, I got that. But now you're in the house with one another on a regular basis. And it changes things. And it shows you a little bit about our relationship. How do I feel about that person? Do I truly love that person? If the answer is yes, you know, things are good. The answer is no, something that maybe you need to go back and pray about.
Mm-hmm.
And prayer always has that communication, always has to be first. But God asked that question. I've done all these things for everybody. And you know what? It's still not good enough. Could you imagine? It's still not good enough. I was going to say, I will strike them down with a plague and destroy them. But I will make you into a nation greater and stronger and stronger than they. So God had a plan in mind, you know, because you can get God pretty angry. And they were getting God pretty angry. Now, once again, this is going to continue later on. But this is where Moses comes in and steps in for us. And this is, believe it or not, tells a little bit about ourselves and our grandparents and our great-great-grandparents and us also, because prayer is powerful. Think about the prayers that your grandma said for you. Think about the prayers that you're saying for your kids. This is something that Moses is giving that he had to do, because God was saying, you know what? It's time to turn the earth around again. But when you speak in prayer, communicate with God, you know what? You change things. And we have to constantly put everyone in prayer. We talk about praying for our community leaders. We talk about praying for those that are in charge. We do that for a particular reason. Not just for the sake of making that prayer, but you know what? Well, then God's going to take some action. And he's going to put things right. And we have to believe that he's going to put things right. And we'll find out pretty long. And next week, what's going to happen? Because the Israelites, they were some rebellious people. And you know what? From time to time, we are rebellious people. But we have to be on board and know what God's doing for us, what's his best for us. He's going to chastise us from time to time, but he's doing what's right for us. And we are truly a blessed people.
Yes, we are.
We are truly a blessed people. I count my blessings each and every day. My wife is underneath the weather, but she's truly blessed. You know, the blessing is that, you know, she looks at Olivia, Alex, Darnell, Marlena, they're her own. And she loves them the same. And she knows that, you know what, they all have those different personalities. But that's okay. But that's a blessing. It really is. Make sure that, you know what, take my medicine on a regular basis, that's truly a blessing. Sometimes I don't want to take my medicine. Sometimes I don't want to take those shots, but I have someone to keep saying that. And then I hear the eye, when you get a little older, you hear the eye of the little one back there telling you what you told them in the past and telling you now. One day she goes, Dad, eat more vegetables. Dad, drink more water. You're not doing enough. You're not doing enough. These are the things that I used to say that way, but it's come back here. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yes, I'm truly blessed. And we are all truly blessed. But we just got to get rid of that rebellious side of us. It's God. It does come into play. And it can really just beat us up. Those few people at work can make you go totally different.
Amen.
Those few people on the outside can make you go totally different. We just have to keep our on the right track. On a regular basis. So I hope you got a little bit out of the lesson. These have been some pretty good lessons. The Israelites, they teach us a lot about ourselves. And always I ask that you continue to pray for my family, my daughter, my sons, myself, as I do the same for you.
Amen.
This is the day.
Children who wants to live faithfully before the Lord. obedient to God and His Word. Mm. And as we read the book of Psalms, one senses an atmosphere of encouragement and the praises that it fills within us. We rejoice in the praises to God, always following the obedience of His people as they stay truthful to His Word in every situation in our life. Amen? Amen. And our song this morning is going to be Psalm 91. Good morning. Yes, what is your emergency? All right. And that's why you dialed 911? Thank you. This morning is Psalm 91. Mm. God is our refuge. Amen. 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 And God is saying this morning, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Mm-hmm. And you know, when you have an emergency and you need to be rushed to the hospital or to the emergency room, the number you dial is 911. And God is saying to His children this morning, I am your emergency call. And all you have to do is dial 911. Psalm 91. And he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Every one of us should have a secret place where we go in and talk to the Lord, Abba Father. You got that secret, quiet place. Well, you know that when you go into God, God is going to answer your prayer. That's why God said, call unto me and I'll answer you. And I'm going to show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Then say, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. And God is telling each and every one of us, trust in the Lord. Put all your trust in Him. Trust in the Lord and lean not to your own understanding. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snares of the flower and from the noose of pleasant. And you know, everybody's been, the whole wide world has been under attack. With the COVID-19, the COVID virus, 19, the killing, the stealing, everything going on in our world. This is God's world, but we are still in. Amen? The pestilence that caused death, dangers to our welfare, to our society, and we will have unknown trouble. Amen?
Amen.
They have not, they had no specific race or color. It hit us all. Amen. But we know that we can call on and we can continue to trust in the Lord and trust in His Word. He said, because my word will not turn back to me void, but it's going to prosper the thing wherein we send it. He shall cover thee with his feather, and under his wing thou shalt trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckle. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day. We all have misfortune in our life. Anything can come. We know not when it's coming, but we know that we can trust in the Lord and lean not to our own understanding. And with this pandemic, not only that, for 1 year after God gave it to me, I gave it to the church that it was going to come. Prepare yourself. Are you ready? Because Jesus is coming soon. Nora preached for 120 years. But what happened? Only 8 souls were saved. Nobody was listening. They continued to do what they wanted to do. God is saying to all his people, turn back to me. Because Jesus is coming soon. And how soon is soon? We don't know. But we got to continue on to look to the hill from which cometh our help. All of our help is coming from the Lord. Amen. And in Matthew chapter 24, in verse 6, and God said, and ye shall hear wars, rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must what? Must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famine and pestilence and earthquake in various places. And as we hear daily earthquakes, famine, pestilence, all over the world is happening. But God tell us, be strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. He is with his children. He'll never leave us nor forsake us. Amen?
Amen.
And God tell us, fret not thyself, or evildoer. Neither be thy enemy working in iniquity, because soon he's going to cut them off. The battle is not ours. The battle is God. We are covered with the blood of Jesus. Nor for the person that walk in darkness, nor for the destruction that waits at noonday. We see things happening around us each and every day. Mm-hmm. And God telling us to fear not. For behold, I am with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. He said, 1,000 shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh to thee. You don't know who is against you. But when they come against you, God said, 1,000 shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh to thee. Fret not thyself, or evildoer. Neither be thy enemy against the worker of iniquity, because soon God going to cut them off. The enemies of the Lord is fed as a lamb. And you got to remember that the Lord is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? Whom shall you be afraid of? No one. Because you and I belong to the Most High God, who owns heaven and earth. He owns everything and everybody. He even owns the devil. Amen? God owns the devil. Read the book of Job and see. God said, look, you go ahead. You can touch everything. You can take everything you want from Job. But you can't take the way Job feels about me. God knew God know us. He know our beginning, and he know our end. And that's why God said, only with thy eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. He said, touch not my anointed, and do my prophets no harm. Do God's children no harm. Because you going to be rewarded by God, but it won't be a good reward. Amen? Amen. Being disobedient to what thus said the Lord will cause problems and trouble, not only on you, but upon your family. And that's why we all have to be very careful. This pandemic was no surprise to me. Amen? Because God said, because thou have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. Because the blood of Jesus is over your household. For me and my house, we're going to do what? We're going to serve the Lord. And if you don't like serving the Lord, you can take the front door or the back door. Either one. Because God is in control. God owns heaven and he owns hell. Amen? Amen. So if God said no plague going to come night thy dwelling, then there's no plague that's going to come night my dwelling. Because he's going to keep all evil away from us. Because he's going to give us what? He's going to give his angels charge over us to keep us in all thy ways. God shows you things before some time, before it ever happened. But are we going to be obedient to what he showed us? Amen? God said, they shall bear thee up in thy hand, lest thou dash thy feet against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion, even the young lion, and the dragon shall thou trample on the feet. We all got snakes, and we don't know who the snakes are. Huh?
Amen.
Amen. They can be laughing and grinning in your face and cutting your throat before three of us cut yourself. Amen. Jesus had 12 disciples. And out of the 12, one betrayed him. But Jesus didn't harm him. He let him bring harm to himself. Amen. That's why he tells us, love your enemies. Pray for the one that spies and use you. And bless those that curse you. Amen? Love everybody. Because God knows the beginning and he knows the end. And God has given us as his children a discerning spirit. You're able to discern both good and evil. God have given us, as you know, I heard Brother Dick say, we have the wisdom of God. If any man like wisdom and knowledge, let him ask who? Ask God. God will show you. I'm a living witness. But God said, a fool will tell all his heart. Amen? Amen. Some things are to be kept secret. The secret things belong to God. And he shows those things to his children whenever he feels that they really need to know. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Because he has set his love upon me. God loves us. God loves his children. Just like we love our little babies, our little ones. That's mine back there, too. Because when my little niece came to me and told me that she might not make it, no, we don't do it that way. We talk to Abba Father. And look what God did. Amen? Amen. God is a great God. He loves us. For God so loved this world Can you imagine loving this world that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus? That whosoever believes in him should not perish, but what? Have everlasting life. Amen? I look at Olivia and over there, and I kept playing the tape for a while. I thought maybe she was going to tell me and her, and now that Javonna was going to tell me to stop playing it. They used to sing and on the choir, and now you look, they traveling and living in a big city as California. Telling me that she just left New York. I said, New York? You can go to New York and California, you can travel all over the world. Amen. Amen. They done grown up now and you just can't, well, you can believe it. But God is watching over all of them. Amen.
Amen.
Because he has set his love upon me, that's why we deliver him. I will set him on high because he knows my name. God said, you shall call upon me and I will answer you. I will be with him in trouble. Whatever trouble comes, God is right there by your side. By your side and my side. Because he said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. God said, I'm going to deliver you and I'm going to honor you. I will deliver you and honor you.
Amen.
Amen. And God said, with long life, will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. God is going to show you your freedom. And my freedom. Amen.
Amen.
With long life. Brother Dickie was saying, we look at Pastor. Long life. 94 years old. Amen. God is good. God promised that. God is a God that can't and will not lie. He said it. And that's it, and it's done. Amen? And when we have an emergency, all we got to do is dwell in our secret place of the Most High. And dial 911. And know that Jesus is there to answer and deliver you. And set you free.
Amen.
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 Amen. And when I look at the young girls now and all the girls that come past and I done helped, and they doing good. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Obedience is better than sacrifice. It's the real world out there that we're living in. Amen? And now, get ready. Because this is not over. God is still speaking. Amen? And the shortage that's happening in the world, ask God, and God will lead you, because he said he never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. So now, and it's getting ready to be winter time. God has been giving us some good weather.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that right? Deacon
James.
Yes. Amen. God said, whatever you ask the Father in his name, that will he do that the Father may be glorified in the Son.
Amen.
Do you know I ask God for a few more good days for mother? Amen?
Amen.
My son, the deacon, told me that it was going to be cold. I said, not right now. Amen?
Amen.
And would you ask God? That's your best friend that you have in the world. You can go to him anytime. You can call him up. He's not busy. He's not going to push the button to keep from answering you. He's going to answer your call as soon as you call. As you begin to talk with him. Because he's with us right now.
Amen.
Right now. He's dwelling in his house. And he's with us each and every moment. He decided to wake us up again this morning. Amen. Amen. And look how he has kept our loneliness. Amen. We're blessed. And before Jesus come, and before it's all over with, the house of God is going to be full. Because they're going to know they need a hiding place. And that hiding place is going to be in Jesus.
Amen.
And we got to remember that God is a God of love. He's a God of mercy. And he's a God of judgment. And when we keep on being disobedient, then judgment is on. Amen.
Amen.
He said it, and he will do it. And it's nothing that you and I can do but continue on to pray for one another. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Are you happy?
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Amen. All right. So we're going to go and enjoy the rest of the day. Jesus, and enjoy the week. Thank God for the rain, because he said what? He gives us rain in due season. Amen.
Amen.
There's no need of nobody. This is his earth. He knows how much to give and what to give and what not to give. Amen?
Amen.
Isn't that something? God is real. God is real. As Mother Rogers used to say, my God is real.
Amen.
And he's real within my soul.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So prepare yourself. Get ready for the present. And ask God what he would have you to do and what he would have you to get and to have in the next go-around. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Everybody happy?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. All right. We're finished. We're going to go. And enjoy the rest of the day and the week. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're going to do safe. Safe flight back to California. Go back to California. We'll see you again this summer. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Make sure you tell Danielle knows I said hello. And hope to see him soon again, too. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. before we...